It's our first numbers game, and Neil, you get to pick.
Can I have one from the top, please, and any other five?
You can indeed. Thank you, Neil. Let's go from the bottom. Five little ones, and they are 1, 3, 9, 10, and another one, and the large one, 25. And your target, 493.
493, and here's the clock. Did you get it?
No, I got 492.
David?
491.
Neil? 492.
3 minus 1 is 2.
Yes.
Times by 10 is 20. I think I've gone wrong. Times by 25.
500.
Oh, no, not. 9 minus 1 is 8. And take it away.
The second one. Yeah, not gone wrong at all. One away.
Rachel, can you get it done?
Yes.
493?
Similar method, actually. 3 minus 1 is 2. But then 25 times 10 is 250. Add the second one here, 251, before you times by 2, and you get 502, and you can take away the 9. 493.
Who needs computers, I think, or calculators? You're amazing. So, with the scores at 14 for Neil and 14 for David, it's time for a tea time teaser. The teaser is no freaks. And the clue is, even the freaks have given up on you. That is, even the freaks have given up on you. See you in a few minutes. Welcome back. I left you with the clue. Even the freaks have given up on you. The answer is forsaken. Now, David, it's your choice at the numbers.
I've one large and the rest small, please.
You can indeed. Thank you, David. One large. Five little coming up. See if this can separate you two. The five little numbers are 4, 8, 3, 9, and 9. And the large one, 100. And your target, very small, 1, 2, 3.
123, and here comes the clock. David, how did you do?
1, 2, 3.
Oh, and Neil?
1, 2, 3.
OK. Prove how you did it, Neil.
I did 9 times 3 is 27. -4 is 23. And then add it to 100.
As easy as ABC, that one.
David, did you do it in the same way?
No, I didn't. 8 divided by 4 is 2.
Yep.
100 plus 9 plus 9 plus 2 plus 3. It's 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, lots of ways for this easy peasy one.
And now we can give ourselves a rest as we wallow in the wisdom of our Dictionary Corner guest, the one and only Christopher Biggins. Neil, it's your choice of numbers.
Can I have one from the top and five small ones, please?
Another one big. Five little combo coming up. Thank you, Neil. Let's have a look what we have this time. Numbers 3, 3, 1, 10, 6, and the big one, 25. And your target, 610.
610, your 30 seconds start now. Thank you. on target?
Yeah, 6:10.
Ooh, David?
6:03.
Oh, OK. Neil, how did you get to 6:10?
I did 3, add 1 is 4.
4.
Times by 6.
24.
Times by 25.
600.
And then add the 10.
Nicely done. 6:10.
And with the scores at 51 for Neil and 41 for David, here's today's second teaser. And the teaser is wire pigs. And the clue? Did Mr. Mason wear these? Did Mr. Mason wear these? See you in a minute. Welcome back. And I left you with the clue, did Mr. Mason wear these? And the answer is periwigs. Susie?
You can still see periwigs today if you go to court. Judges and barristers still wear them. So they're highly styled wigs that were once very fashionable. And the peri bit is short for peruke, which is French for a wig.
Thank you very much.
So it's wig, really.
David, it's your choice for the final numbers.
One large and the rest small.
Thank you, David. One large, five little, but I want more of a challenge. Come on, numbers. Give us something interesting. This time we have 1, 7, 2, 6, 7, and the large one, 50. And the final target of the day, 233.
233, and off we go. David, how did you do?
I lost it.
Oh, Neil, how did you
do? I think I got 233, but I've not written it down.
OK. Well, let's... How did you approximate? How did you...
50 minus 2.
Yep, sounds good.
6 minus 1.
5.
And then multiply them together.
240.
And then minus the 7.
Perfect, 233.
Are there any other ways, Rachel, of getting to 233?
You could have done 50 minus 7 minus 2 minus 1 for 40 times by 6 and take the 7. Quite a few ways for this one. They generally are with the one large.
Can I just ask you, Rachel, please, is there any hope for me? Honestly, I think I must be numbers blind as opposed to word blind.
There's no such thing. If I lock you in a room with me for a couple of hours, you'll have them, I promise you. Are you up for it?
Or will I get my knuckles wrapped if I can't get it?
I'm a very nice teacher. Carrots rather than sticks.
Thank you. So, with the scores at 88 for Neil and 55 for David, it's time for the final round. Fingers on buzzers, please reveal today's countdown conundrum.
I think it's wrong.
Give it a whirl.
Incendia. It's not right.
Well, let's have a look. Rest of the time to you, David. Any chance?
No.
No? OK. All right. Christopher, have you any idea?
No idea ever.
Susie?
No. Too many E's for what I wanted it to be.
Yeah.
OK, Rachel, put us out of our misery.
We're going to need to have a look at this one.
Here comes the reveal. Ah, residence. OK. Well, commiserations for David, but you at least get a goodie bag.
Thank you.
Did you enjoy yourself?
I did. Appreciated the time here.
And it was so lovely to have you. Wow. And it's very well done to Neil. We'll see you again tomorrow. And it's goodbye to Susie and goodbye to Biggins. And Rachel?
And what's on your jukebox at the end of the day?
Oh, let me think, let me think. It is not Elvis Presley. It's probably Ray Charles. Oh. But in the meantime, many thanks to you for watching and goodbye.